In this video, we will create the database inside in the database server. To do this, we have to click in this button here, in the Create Database button. So again, we have to fill some important informations here, but especially the database name. So in this case, I already included that here in my notepad. So let me copy this information and paste over there. Okay, so here, want to use SQL Elasticsearch? No. So workload environment and development and compute plus storage. Here we have to configure our database. So let's click on here. In service tier, we are going to choose, let me see here, the basic for less demanding workloads. Let's include it here, let's click in the apply button here. After to this, we are going to the next in networking. So here in this page, we have to include our IP address. So in this case, add current client IP address for choose the option here, yes option. So we are not using private endpoint. So in this case, let's jump this option here. So let's go to the security tab. So in this page, we have some important informations about Microsoft Defender for SQL. Again, if you want to enable Microsoft Defender for SQL just to try out, it is an option for you. But just for demo purposes, I will choose this option here, not now option. So let's go to the additional settings. So here in additional settings tab, we can see a data source. For example, if you already have any database to restore, you can use these options here, backup or sample. In this case, for demo purposes, we use this non-option here. Here's a database collation just for define some rules that sort of compare data. And even we can see an option about a maintenance window, but we don't need to change anything here. So let's click in the review plus create button. We can see all the information that we included to create a new SQL database inside our database server. So let's click on the create button here. So again, we received the message your deployment is complete. So let's click on the button in the go to resource button. As you can see, we can see our dashboard here. We can see the overview, the activity log, all the information related with this database. But let's focus in this option here, query editor. Inside this option here is very interesting because it's here that we can do a SQL query here in the cloud. So probably we are going to use a lot of this option here. And if you want to see the connection strings, you can go to settings, connection strings in different programming languages such as Golang, PHP, ODBC, JDBC, or even .NET. So there's a good information here. But let me show you all the thing here. Inside of this database, we can see especially the server name here. As you can see here, this information is pretty important to us. So try to copy this information here. Let's include here in my notepad here. And now inside in our Azure database here, Azure SQL databases, actually Azure SQL, and again this server here that we created before. And here in the settings in SQL databases, we can see the recently database that we recently created. So now in the next video, we are going to do the same thing, but right now to create a shadow database. So see you in the next video.